Video, subscribe to my channel, hit the like button. Any videos y'all want me to react to, hit me up. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, the Stardust app at JVLewis77. Check out the Patreon at JVLewis and hit the notification button to be alerted when I post new videos. Now, what I'm about to react to is this week's top 10 moments in Monday Night Raw. Now, we got the completion of the draft, and the draft was pretty predictable. A lot of people stayed with their same brands. A few little, you know what I'm saying, like, But me, I'm more interested about the free agents, the people who didn't get drafted, so they can go wherever they want. Now, I know on FS1 today that that's supposed to be like an hour special or something like that. And I know they say, they got to midnight tonight, whatever time zone that they have to decide to sign. And then obviously you got a lot of people who's hurt right now who could pop up and show up whenever, so... Like I said, it wasn't what I expected. I expected a full draft. So this whole free agent thing and the fact that somebody like Cesaro didn't get drafted, I'm like, what the fuck? Huh? But Cesaro is fighting at Crown Jewel. He fighting Mansoor, you know, which is gonna be a great match, but still, like, the biggest questions I got is Naomi and the Usos. What's gonna happen with them? I would like to see all of them on SmackDown because, as y'all seen, couples are staying together, and I think it would benefit, especially Raw is stacked in the tag team division. I think SmackDown needs the Usos. SmackDown really needs like a big face in the women's division. Naomi fits that because it's like you got heels right now. You got more heels than faces, so Naomi would fit that bill unless they turn Lacey face, but I doubt it. I don't think there's no way she could be a face, but... Yeah. Like I say, a lot of people stayed on SmackDown. A lot of people stayed on Raw. You know, I do like what SmackDown did. You know, like I say, it's a 2-hour show. So, like I say, Sasha, Roman, Braun, Baron Corbin was a surprise. So, it's going to be interesting. Like, Ali stayed on SmackDown. I think that's cool because it's like Raw got all of the young talent. You know, I mean, they got Aleister Black, they got Cedric, they got Buddy Murphy, Ricochet. It's like, damn, Paul Heyman ain't playing with these young guys. Like, let's make something out of y'all, catch Street Profits, you know? So, all right, y'all. With that being said, go ahead and check out this top 10. Yo, this spot right here,
Spider-Man.
This was a damn good match. Ricochet and Apollo was good last week. Ricochet and Sheldon. Now, can we do something with Sheldon on Raw? Can we actually do something? Because it was a waste bringing him back. Can we do something with Sheldon?
Asuka now the little superstar. Whoa. No one there for the instant elbow, but I don't think Lacey Evans realizes that women's right knocked out Kairi Sane, but Asuka's legal.
The dreaded Asuka roll up.
Rolls up Lacey Evans in the
Kabuki. Let me get that. Let me get that. Here are your winners, the WWE Women's. Come on, get Kairi. Get Kairi. Get her. Kabuki Warriors. Get her. Get your girl. Get your girl.
Welcome to the fam. Just wrap it up, Lord. You got it.
Welcome to the
fans. Oh! Bullying. Oh! Man, they always jumping somebody, man. Come on, man. Man, they beat up Cedric. Man, they beat up Street Profits. But the Street Profits not going to take that shit lying down, though. Street Profits going to get them a third guy, and it's going down.
Young now looking for a pin.
Oh, it may, nope.
Nice.
Getting turned around, and quickly we saw that last week on Raw, a quick submission by Aleister Black and a quick tap out by Eric Young.
It was good to see Eric Young, man, but it's like, can we do something with Eric Young?
By submission, Aleister Black! And now with one arm and... Wait a minute! Yes! Yes!
And that's why we picked up Zelina, too. She's every bit as
dangerous. Oh, yeah. Nigga, Andrade. Yeah, Andrade. Raw is stacked for young talent, man.
You should have seen that, but you didn't. Looking for the hammerlock DDT. Andrade puts it in the center of the ring. Good night, nurse. Into the cover. And the USA executives have to be happy with the blue chippers they drafted tonight. Here is your winner.
Okay, maybe finally Andrade will be a major player, as we thought he was going to be on SmackDown.
Whoa.
The fuck? Like. What?
Murphy now looking for Murphy's Law. Can he connect? Oh. Murphy got all of it. Buddy Murphy into the cover. Good night, Cedric Alexander.
What a match. Yo, these two gonna tear it up, man. Buddy. Like I say, the only thing is, the only sad part is both of them can't get over at the same time. It's either gonna be one or the other.
Belief again, King. To Dio's point, Charlotte Flair.
Oh, oh shit, Charlotte. Back to back losses. What's going on, Queen? What's going on, Queen?
Charlotte Flair lost focus just for a straight second. The man capitalized, and the man brings the top pick here to Monday Night Raw.
Oh no.
Ziggler goes up.
Oh no.
Ziggler goes down.
Woo!
Viking experience, and the Viking Raiders are the new Raw Tag Team Champions.
And I'm happy for them cats, man, because everybody was shitting on them, having all them squash matches. Them squash matches was needed. Then they took out, man, and they took out some major players, man. Happy for these cats, man.
It down.
Okay. When Seth jumped on Bray out the blue, that shit fucked me up, because I ain't see that shit coming. And see, I went back. And Ramblin' Rabbit was saying Seth was coming, but I didn't pay attention to that. I wasn't really paying attention to what all Ramblin' Rabbit was saying. Now, it's funny that Seth is going to fight Bray at a Crown Jewel for the championship. Now, usually these Crown Jewel pay-per-views really don't have no impact on the storylines. They just one-offs, except for that Shane Best in the World bullshit. But, and it's kind of weird because Bray was on SmackDown. And then as far as that show that's going to be on FS1, Booker T was talking about a blockbuster trade. So does that mean Bray's coming back to Raw? Makes you wonder. It makes you wonder. So if it's a trade, a blockbuster, then is it going to be one of them things when Triple H was on SmackDown years ago and they traded the Dudleys and Booker T to SmackDown for him? And then it started that whole thing where Booker T was mad and was like, man, this is the minor leagues right here on SmackDown. You know what I'm saying? But SmackDown was when Booker T had one of his best runs, you know. But y'all see where I'm going. So we're going to have to see what's going to happen with this special. And like I say, I want to see where everybody who didn't get drafted end up. Because you still got, man, they did all this hype for AOP and it's like, yo, AOP didn't even get drafted. I mean, you got people like Dana, Mojo, who else didn't get drafted? There was a lot of people that didn't get drafted. And then think about all the people that's hurt. Man, Ruby, what's going to happen with her? You know, because didn't they say people that was weren't eligible to be drafted, but they got drafted anyway? Jinder Mahal got drafted. Man, Mandy and Sonya didn't get drafted. Well, Mandy, but Sonya, she wasn't drafted. You know what I mean? It's like, wow. So, we going to have to see. But, all right, y'all. Let me know what y'all think about the draft. Punk-ass Crown Jewel. Okay. The whole Braun and Tyson Fury thing, like, what the fuck was that? Yeah. Anyway. Let me know what y'all think about the draft. Y'all like the picks. Who y'all think should have went where? What do y'all think about the free agents that's out there? Like I said, man, Cesaro, Naomi, the Usos, AOP, you know what I mean? Those are the people who I'm most, like, hyped for to see where they go. Because I think all of them could make a major impact coming up. Barring booking. That is the most important thing. Like I say, Cesaro, matter of fact, put Cesaro on SmackDown. Matter of fact, put all of them on SmackDown. AOP, the Usos, Naomi, Cesaro, put all of them on SmackDown. You know, because I think, but see, that's the thing, man. This isn't the SmackDown of old. You know what I mean? With the whole Fox thing and the way they pushing certain stuff, it's like, man, we'll have to see. But I just think Raw is so stacked. It's kind of like it's reversed. It's like SmackDown probably going to be the A show, but it's going to be like typical Vince McMahon shit. And it's like Raw is going to be the land of opportunity. You know what I mean? So we just going to have to see. So with that being said, subscribe to my channel. Hit the like button. JV Lewis. Y'all be safe out here. Catch y'all on the rebound. Donate to the Patreon. $1 tier. Hit the notification button. And I'll see y'all good people next video. Peace.